You'll be shocked as IGP makes a statement about the Southeast, that the Southeast has such a large population, you know, and people should not misunderstand this. What he said is rather, because people have been saying there is no reason, yeah, for the government to keep such a large population of security agencies in the Southeast. After all, if you look at the map of Nigeria, you will see that the Southeast is not that large. Okay, it's not such a very big place, so to say. However, this is one of the places that is most concentrated with security agents. Why? Buhari's administration and government want to ensure that they get rid, okay, of the young people to reduce the population so that they can have their Fulanis infiltrate into the land of the people. Now, the new IGP of police said, oh, the Southeast has such a large population. He's speaking hypothetically in the sense that they can continue to do what they want to do. The population they are talking about, they've termed the Southeast. Remember that they said, the federal government said, IPOB and the rest, said that they are whatever they have called them. And so this is why they have a free raid and a free ride to continue to, you know, misbehave towards these people and do things that are morally, constitutionally wrong. You see, please do not forget to give us a thumbs up, like us, share, subscribe. Let's get all the details. For a while now, many Nigerians have continued to query why there is heavy presence of security officers in the Southeast region, why bandits are busy laundering deadly attacks on the Northeast. Many Nigerians, most of the heavily armed security officers, are supposed to be deployed to the north to address the security situation and the bandit raging over that region. But this has not happened. This saw some newsmen during a briefing in Abuja ask the Nigerian Inspector General of Police, IGP, for the reason why there is heavy presence of security agencies in the Southeast instead of the North, where they truly need help. While addressing the question, the IGP stated that the Southeast has a large population, unlike the North, with a large land mass. According to him, the Southeast has a large population of people occupying small space. Consequently, the large population presence requires more security officers. Since the report emerged a couple of hours ago, many Nigerians have continued to misinterpret the statement that the Southeast region has a higher number of inhabitants than the Northern region. And that's true. That's true. We know what is going on in the north. We know that it's all a deceit to make it look like, you know, they have that population, you know, all because so that during census they can, you know, they will be able to declare to say that they did this, they did that. That's why they are doing what they are doing. It's not because they have a large population. That statement is a very correct statement, okay? So this is what is going on. The IGP was asked, why are you people doing this? Why is it that you are taking all your troops, okay, all the troops, all road leads to the north, when truly, sincerely speaking, the north, you know, all road leads to the south, when the north is the one that really needs, you know, the heavy presence of security? They've not been able to answer that question adequately. You know why? You know why? They are the reason. They know exactly what they are doing. They intend to depopulate the north. It's intentional. And the people they are eliminating are the indigenous people of the north so that they can, you know, infiltrate and begin to bring in their own people. Go and find out. You will find out now that, you know, over 108, you know, communities in Plateau State has been renamed by Fulanis. Renamed by Fulanis. And the federal government of Nigeria has nothing to say. So when you have terrible things going on like this, you'll be wondering exactly what is going on. You will be wondering exactly what is going on. So this is what we are asking, and this is what we are talking about. You know, these people, they know exactly what they are doing. It's a wicked game and agenda ongoing. Okay, it's a wicked game and a wicked agenda ongoing. So Nigerians, the time to speak out, the time to act is now. We cannot pretend that these things are not happening. Listen, guys, they are sincerely, truly happening. So let's come out of this deceit we keep doing to one another, to our very own self. Let's come out of it and let us face the truth and let us say it as it is. There are a lot of oppression going on right now. There are a lot of misunderstanding happening right now. You know, if we don't rise up from this very current predicament we've come to find ourselves, you'll be shocked at some of the things ongoing today. Listen, my people, listen. The IGP of police, Inspector General of Police, or whatever you call him, army, and I mean all the security agencies in the country, where are they from? What religion are they? It ought not to be so. There's supposed to be diversity, difference, everybody being represented so that some people do not infringe, you know, using their own mind and their own perspective to infringe on others. It ought not to be so. But sadly, this is what is going on right now. This is what is happening. This is what is happening. The time to wake up, the time to rise up and to say the truth is now. You know, the time to rise up is now. So listen, my people, this is what is going on. Listen, every one of us must not pretend. Okay? None of us must pretend. The Southeast is under a siege. The Southeast is under a siege. It is under a siege. Listen, guys, it is under a siege. What have they done? What is their crime? Because they do not share the same ideology with the federal government, with Muhammadu Buhari. Hence, they are the ones being oppressed. And Buhari's government, if you hear what Buhari said, when we heard that they said they found oil in Gombe, you know, and one other of the northern states, not really oil, so fragment or, you know, a possibility of oil. Guess what? He said, yes, now he cannot deal with the Niger Delta. That was what he said. So now he can deal with the Niger Delta. Listen, guys, please do not forget to give us a thumbs up, like us, share, subscribe. Click on the notification button so you can get all our latest news. God bless you. Have a lovely day. Bye for now. Bye.